My name's Rachel Smith and I'm Drawings Conservator at the Royal Collection Trust, and I work in the Paper Conservation Studio, which is based in Windsor Castle. For the last 18 months, I've been conserving a whole range of Indian artworks for our upcoming exhibition. They're quite a wide range, from about 400 years of history, from all across the subcontinent. We always check all the objects that go into exhibitions to make sure that they're strong enough and stable enough. Inevitably, with exhibitions, there's a lot of handling and photography and transport. These objects are particularly fragile. Paper supports from India suffer from all the usual wear and tear that European paper supports do, losses through handling, insect damage, so I'm working to stabilise those areas. The really important first step in conservation is always to examine the artworks as carefully as possible so that we can formulate an appropriate conservation treatment for them. We can look at the paintings under ultraviolet light, and that gives us some information about which pigments were used. Another method of examination is using infrared radiation. The infrared is able to see through some of the upper paint layers, so it allows us to see through to what's underneath, and in this case we found that there's a really interesting underdrawing. We've actually uncovered a whole host of little demon figures that didn't make it to the final painting. And this tells us that the artists were making changes as they went along, so they were still working out their ideas on this very sheet of paper. This painting is one from a series. It's a Hindi text, the Gita Govinda. So a lot of the damage to the paint layer is on a tiny, tiny scale and you don't necessarily see it with the naked eye. So I always check the surfaces through the microscope and I use a very strong raking light which shines across the surface and really highlights any lifting or buckling of the paint. Where I see flakes which are loose, then I go in with a tiny amount of adhesive. And I'm just applying tiny amounts around the edges of lifting flakes, and then that gets sucked underneath where it's needed between the paint and the paper support, so that with any handling, with the vibrations of transport, that paint is securely attached and it won't become loose. This is a page from an album known as a maraca, which translates as scrapbook. But this is a scrapbook taken to a very high art form. These pages are 400 years old and they show signs of their age. There's a little bit of water damage, there are small tears from handling. My work is to infill those. The first stage, I choose my repair paper. I then tone it with watercolour to a colour sympathetic to the original. I trace the area of damage with tracing paper, and I then place my repair paper on top and with a sharp scalpel cut it out. The final step then is to paste the repair. I use an adhesive which I know will be reversible. If somebody in 50 years' time or 100 years' time decides that they're not appropriate or that they have the technology to do it better, I want them to be able to remove what I've done. So I use a fairly weak adhesive, I paste it out, and then very carefully position the repair into the area of loss. I want my repairs to be very discreet from a distance so that you can appreciate the whole object, but if you look very closely, it's important that they're obvious, that they're modern repairs. I'm treating individual pages from a manuscript. It's called the Hamsa of Navai. The manuscript was disbound for conservation because it was no longer safe for handling. And the main problem with it was that the copper pigment had been painted as a decorative frame on every single page. The copper pigment eats into the paper and makes it much weaker. So with handling of the manuscript, with turning of the pages, we actually started to get fracturing along that ruling line on every single page. This type of repair is quite difficult because the chemical process where the pigment eats through the paper is actually catalyzed by any water. So if I apply a wet repair paper, that will actually make the damage accelerate over time. So I design my repairs to introduce the most minimal amount of moisture possible. So I choose my repair paper, I tone it with watercolour to make it as discreet as possible, and then I apply a layer of adhesive and allow that to dry. I then simply cut a narrow strip off and reactivate the adhesive using a small amount of water mixed with alcohol, and then I can lay the repair paper down onto the copper ruling. I find conservation work incredibly satisfying. At the end of the day, I can see what I've done, how I've improved the object. And these objects are now safe to go on exhibition. They're also looking their best so that the public can enjoy them as the works of incredible art that they are. But also they are conserved for the future, so they will be stable now for researchers to come in and study them, to be handled and to be enjoyed for generations to come.